Now, looking forward, what we've seen from both quarterbacks, we want to take a moment to really talk about, hey, who's going to be, for the long term, the better quarterback? Since their seasons are pretty much over, let's look ahead to the future. Mm-hmm. Now, keep in mind, as you see the note at the bottom, you've got Lawrence and Wilson. They played the different amount of games, right? You've got right. Lawrence playing 15 games, Wilson playing 11. Mm-hmm. Lawrence passing for more yards, more the pocket passer kind of guy.
Yeah.
Zach Wilson's 7-11 interception, touchdown interception ratio, whereas Lawrence, not that better either. I mean, mm-hmm. 9 touchdowns to 14 interceptions.
Yeah.
Lawrence a little bit more accurate and just a slightly better quarterback rating. So pretty much you could just say like, oh, well, these guys are pretty much neck and neck at this point. I can tell you that I watch a lot of football and I've seen a lot of these players play. And I am telling you right now, if from just the eye test, looking 2021, Zach Wilson or Trevor Lawrence, who was the better person? To me, it was Zach Wilson.
Yeah.
Right? But do I think who's going to have a better career? I think it's going to be Trevor Lawrence as well.
Yeah.
Trevor Lawrence, Zach Wilson, who do you got?
I'm going to go with Trevor Lawrence. And it's no knock to Zach Wilson. You know, we talked about yesterday how Zach is he's raw. Still got a lot of unproven talent. And obviously, it's hard to win with the Jets organization. It's, as it is, the hard to win in the NFL. But it all goes back to what kind of coach do you have in place. Colin Cowherd talked about it best. You know, number one, do you have a head coach? Number two, do you have a quarterback? Number three, do you have an identity? The Jets, they have a head coach. I think Robert Saleh is the guy. You know, and I don't know if you saw yesterday, came back from COVID. Glad to have you back, Coach Saleh. They don't have an identity right now. And the thing with Zach Wilson, although he's thrown for over 2,000 yards this year, he's got sacked 32 times this year. 32 times.
Wow.
And so I feel like he needs us a great supporting cast around him this offseason if the Jets are really going to want to make a push in the AFC East. Down in Jacksonville, you know, Trevor, his numbers are a little bit better, a little over 3,200 yards passing this year. But he hasn't had a great supporting cast around him. And obviously with all the offseason drama with Urban Meyer, you know, he hasn't been able to focus so much on his craft. And we talked about that earlier when you asked me, well, who should be the head coach? And while the names we talked about, Byron Leftwich, you know, Jim Caldwell, Doug Peterson, the reason why I think, again, going back to Doug, he's a player's coach, number one. He's a leader of men, number two. And he's the kind of guy that's going to help build that supporting cast around Trevor. Trevor is a once-in-a-lifetime generation type talent.
Right.
So between the two, I feel like he's more primed to have a better, successful career than Zach Wilson.
And this isn't me knocking on Zach Wilson. I think just from watching Zach Wilson play, he looked great. Actually, after week one, I saw him play against the Carolina Panthers, and he was terrible the first half. And the second half, they still lost the game, but he looked really good. And there's been flashes of that like throughout the season.
And then this past weekend, I think, didn't he broke off for like a 50-yard run or something against the Jaguars? Granted, it's the Jags. The defense not as exactly good. But, yeah, I mean, he's shown flashes. He's got that, and I don't want to compare him to Johnny Manziel, but he's got those flashes of quick feet like Johnny Football. Again, you talk about having the talent around you. You talk about having the right pieces in place to make you successful. And so I honestly feel like whether it's in free agency or in the draft, both these teams – need to look at fixing their offensive lines. Because the number one thing, and I don't mean to use this, one of my favorite movies, The Blind Side. You ever saw that?
Yeah.
By Michael Orr. What did Sandra Bullock say? Whenever you're cutting the checks, what's the first check go to? The mortgage. But what does the second check cut to? The insurance. The insurance is what's going to protect you long term. And so, New York Jets, if you're listening to me out there, you want insurance, build you some offensive linemen to build around you to protect your franchise quarterback. Otherwise, there's going to be a good chance 2-3 years down the road, you're going to be in the top five of the draft looking at another quarterback, and you're going to have Zach Wilson shipped off somewhere else. And who knows, if he has a successful career, whether it's with the Jets or somewhere else, you're going to be scratching your head saying, did I make the right choice?
Good points. Very good points. And, it's about getting the right pieces around you. Zach Wilson, he had Elijah Moore, he had Corey Davis, he had Jameson Crowder, he has Michael Carter. Trevor Lawrence, Marvin Jones, poor coaching, DJ Chark got hurt, James Robinson wasn't utilized like the way they should. Travis Etienne gets hurt at the beginning of the season.
And with Trevor, too, if you notice, what was it last week, right after Urban was axed, you know, he talked about he wants a say in the head coaching search. And Shad Khan, the owner, has granted him, like, you know what? Yeah, we would like your input. Because Trevor knows I'm not going to be the one that's going to hire the head coach. I know it's going to be up to management and ownership to decide that. But if you look at it too with Green Bay with Aaron Rodgers, you know, Aaron Rodgers wanted the GM out, but he wanted certain players in place because he knows his career is on the line.
Right.
You know, he needs those types of pieces around him to make him what he is. And so we're starting to see a trend now where quarterbacks are going to start going to ownership saying, look, you know, if you're going to bring a new head coach into the building to lead this franchise, but to not only set me up for success, I'd like to have a say in that. And I can't discredit him for wanting to do that at all.
No, I mean, it makes sense. It makes perfect sense. So, yeah, we both side with Trevor Lawrence for the longevity of the career is going to look better. 2021, I think Zach Wilson took it over Trevor. But, I mean, again, like we said, get the right pieces around him, get the right head coach. He should be able to ball out. But leave your comments and your thoughts down below in the live chat or down below if you're watching this video later on after we stream. Who do you think is going to have the better career? Is it going to be Trevor Lawrence or Zach Wilson?